elite car, tail of the tape. Lin Hejin is 5 years older than Hirata, 4 inches taller. Hirata's got her by 4 pounds. The reach advantage to Lin by 2 inches. And again, 3 5-minute rounds. This is catch weight, mixed martial arts, and the fight judge as a whole. Here's Dom Lau.
Up next, we have 3 5-minute rounds of a 119-pound catchweight MMA contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, she stands at 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 15 wins and 3 losses. Training out of Kaohsiung MMA, representing China, hey! MMA sister Lin Hejin! Introducing her opponent out of the red corner. She stands at 5 feet 2 inches tall, weighing in at 119 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 5 wins and only 1 loss. Training out of Crazy Bee, representing Japan, Android 18, it's Suke Hirata! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Herb Dean.
All right, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will keep it clean. Touch gloves. Let's do it.
It's Itsuki Hirata and Lin Hejin, second bout on this lead card, the debut of one championship on Prime Video. One Prime Video one. And here we go with bout number two. Hejin with an early inside leg kick to set the tone.
Now I'm expecting Lin Hejin to really utilize that lead leg like she showed me earlier this week. She's got a nice little push kick, but she has to utilize that jab. She has to punish Itsuki every single time Itsuki tries to enter the pocket.
Hejin working that front leg early on. The first of 3 5-minute rounds in this women's MMA matchup.
She's staying busy with that jab with the rangefinder there, and you saw her step in for the first time with that jab to try to touch Itsuki.
Straight right from Hejin. That'll wake you up early in the morning.
Hejin's coming out firing right now.
I'm surprised Izuki's kind of standing in range right there. She's, you know, she's in that range where Lin Hejin can touch her, and so she needs either to get out or decide to get in, make or break that distance.
Mixing it up nicely, some early combinations from Lin Hejin. Again, the main card, less than 90 minutes from now on Prime Video.
At this point, Itsuki doesn't seem to be fazed by anything. She's real relaxed. She's not surprised by Lin Hejin's speed. Able to evade the kick right there. So this is still just a feeling out process, Brent.
The straight right glanced off the left shoulder of Itsuki Hirata.
I like Lin Hejin's center channel weapon. She comes right down the middle with really quick hand speed, and she's mixing in the leg kicks really well. Look at the damage that's starting to build up on the lead leg of Itsuki. Itsuki needs to change things up right now.
Yeah, you can see it right there on the back of that left hamstring. And she's just standing right there in the pocket, in the range where Lin Hejin can touch her.
What's the mindset of Hirata so far? Hasn't done a lot.
I think she's just looking for an opening. There it is, just like that. She gets that single leg, but look, Lin Hejin defends with a front headlock, able to pull right back up to her feet. That's going to build her confidence in this situation right now. Itsuki needs to keep threatening that, but I want to see you be a little more active with the hands. Utilize her jab. You know, start mixing in her leg kicks, because right now, she's getting teed off on it.
Yeah, if Itsuki starts pursuing the takedown like she normally does, she wasn't phased in the Ranzwan fight when Jihin was able to just continually defend the takedown. Like, Itsuki stuck with the game plan. She was eventually able to get her down. She came up on the short end of that match, but nonetheless, she never lost confidence or got frustrated.
Four straight jabs from Hejin, testing at distance. and then backs Hirata off as she went in.
That was nice timing on that overhand right. I think she's starting to figure things out a little bit on the speed of Lin Hexin, because Lin Hexin is looking remarkably fast right now. See, look at that. Again, she slipped out of the way, came over with that right hand. She's been working hard on her boxing, has Itsuki Hirata.
2 minutes left in round one. 3-5 in rounds, and again, the fight judged as a whole, as opposed to round by round.
See, that's a nice weapon, because what it does is it also sets up the single leg takedown, so she can throw that overhand right and go right to the lead leg, get in nice and tight. And I'd like to see Itsuki maybe threaten a little bit more with the level changes, start just feinting things at her.
Absolutely. I think Itsuki's done a good job of studying film here, because Lin Hexin has that fast jab. She also has that nice leg kick, but you can see the chin of Lin Hexin right there where it's reddened. And so there's some little bit of superficial damage, if nothing else, at this point in time. And Hirata is really timing that overhand right well.
Yeah, she's got to start moving away from those leg kicks. She's not checking anything, but she does have at least the sense to back up, but she needs to come right back. She needs to close that distance and really get active with her boxing right now. See, she's trying to time that overhand right, but it seems like that's the only weapon she really seems comfortable with throwing.
Well, the problem with the overhand right now, Mitch, is that Lin Hexin, she's a little bit taller, but she also has these really long arms, so she can stay very rangy and out of the pocket as well.
And what I also like about Lin Hexin, Brent, is her head movement, right? She needs to keep Itsuki Hirata upright as she can, so that Itsuki Hirata doesn't drop down and start attacking those legs.
Couple of knees here from Hirata. Up against the fence is Lin Hexin. First real attack from Hirata so far. You see, you guys mentioned it earlier, that left leg, the back of the leg of Hirata has taken damage early on in this fight.
I know Rich called this a crossroads matchup for both these ladies, but this is a crossroads position.
At the end of round one, Lin Hexin controlled much of it, but a late flurry from the Japanese woman, Itsuki Hirata.
And as Itsuki goes back to her corner, she looks happy with her performance.
She just, because she got that body lock, she was able to feel what Lin Hexin's like.
You have to be more pressure. You have to be more pressure. Have to go striking. You have to go to take down. Opponent very afraid of your striking. You have to go take down first.
Seems like she's out for a walk in the park. All smiles.
Go for it.
Yeah, her corner was telling her that she needs to go for the takedown. I think that based on that, she's been standing in that pocket. Lin Hexin's been able to touch her a lot, and I think in the translation there, they're telling her, like, close the distance, get in on that takedown, let's get to the game plan.
The battle in round two of three in this catchweight battle, women's MMA, second bout of this lead card. One on Prime Video One, Marias versus Johnson 2.
Good movement right now from Itsuki. She looks very calm, very collected. Lin Hexin needs to press a little bit more. She needs to get in and get out, utilize some angles, not just stand there directly in front of her. If she starts to get on her bicycle a little bit and start creating these angles, it's going to be harder for Itsuki Hirata to back her up against the wall, and that's typically where she likes to get the clinch and then look for the takedowns.
You saw that level change from Itsuki Hirata right there, and when she's doing that, she's at least keeping Lin Hexin guessing so that Lin Hexin can't tee off with that jab or start throwing that leg kick. It backs her up. But when she's standing in the pocket like that, Lin Hexin can just tee off.
I know the corner was very confident about the success that Hirata had in that first 5 minutes, but right now, all these little touches, all these little shots that Lin Hexin's able to score are all adding up in the judge's eyes. Itsuki Hirata needs to start controlling this matchup if she wants to walk away a win.
Absolutely. I'm not sure I would have Itsuki Hirata ahead on the scorecards at the end of 5 minutes just based on the first round performance.
Again, it's judged as a whole, the entire three rounds, 5 minutes each.
See, look, Lin Hexin, even though she's, on her back foot and she's moving, she's creating these angles. She's moving, she's not stationary, and that makes her a lot harder to take down.
A couple of inside leg kicks from Hexin, working that jab pretty well as well, measuring that distance with Hirata. 2 minutes into this second round.
And what she's done is she's changed her footwork in this round. Now she's moving to Hirata's weak side, right? So she's not going to get pressed up against the wall, right? She keeps circling away to her left side. Starts her off and gets right back to her game.
Rich, it's got to get frustrating for Hirata every time she goes in. Lin Hichin's so slippery to get out of there.
Yeah, it's very difficult, but Hirata's letting her dictate the pace. See, typically when a fighter comes out, they will take the center of the ring, and you can see Lin Hichin is in the center of the ring right now, but she rarely lets herself get back up outside of that circle, so she knows she has ample space to turn and not get trapped in the corner, so to speak.
Midpoint of round two, midpoint of the fight.
See, look at the activity from Lin Hichin. She's always putting something in the face of Hirata, whether it's a jab, whether it's a leg kick. She's always mixing things in. That's like the first strike that Hirata's even thrown, and it didn't quite connect.
She didn't step forward on that strike. I'm beginning to wonder if she's having trouble moving with that leg, man.
You see that left leg, not just in the back of the leg, but all over on the thigh, red marks for Hirata. She's taking some damage.
Yeah, not only is Lin Hichin controlling the striking aspect of this match, but she's also doing damage, and that's a higher category. Izuki Hirata needs to pick things up. There you go, she needs to get in tight. But see how Lin Hichin keeps circling away from Izuki Hirata's right side? That's gonna be more difficult for Hirata to get in tight or even throw that right hand that she was throwing in the first five.
Yeah, this has been a game of footwork for Lin Hichin. She's managed the range of this fight about 90% of the time, keeping Izuki Hirata exactly where she wants her.
Beautiful mixture of the jab from Hichin and the low leg kicks. 120 in round two.
See, but see how she's feinting? She's trying to keep Hirata guessing by mixing in the feints, throwing these little twitches.
By the bell for sure.
Izuki Hirata was about to lock it in, and the bell ends round number two. Thank goodness for Lin Hichin.
Izuki Hirata is going back to her corner smiling again, but I'm not sure that I would score that as a near finish. You see the entire round here where Lin Hichin is hammering the legs out, controlling the distance, outside leg kicks, inside leg kicks, utilizing her jab really well. And Hirata was able to land that takedown at the end and finally get to that position as they were scrambling on top. But I'm not sure that I would score that as a near finish.
Maybe we just need a little bit more urgency coming from Hirata.
At this point in round three, definitely.
What do you have for us there in Chinese? Are you good with the Chinese?
I understood the Japanese corner much better than I understood Lin Hichin's corner.
Rich, you're responsible for the Chinese sentence.
We're in trouble.
The bell in round three. Who's got the edge? Again, it's judged overall as the entire fight.
Yeah, at this point, the superior striking and the damage to the leg is, you got to give the edge to Lin Hichin. If Izuki Hirata can get into that clinch position a little bit quicker in this 5 minutes right here, she might be able to get a submission, because once she grabs onto something, she got that kimura, she was not letting it go. She tried to take that arm back to Tokyo with her. So she needs to be a little bit more aggressive and urgent when it comes to that takedown.
Yeah, you know, with less than 5 minutes of action left, Hirata's got a lot of work cut out for here, because if that submission at the end of round two was not scored as a near finish, which I don't believe that it necessarily would have been, then I'm not sure even a near finish in round three is enough to overcompensate for all the damage that you see on that leg at this point in time.
Hichin, though, most likely got saved by the bell instead of getting submitted at the end of round two. Straight right, comes back to the left. Nice combinations here from Hichin.
Yeah, that's what Lin Hichin needs to do. She needs to keep those hands in the face, but I like the feint coming from Izuki Hirata, but Lin Hichin is moving well, but now she's stationary. If Izuki Hirata can start to press forward and look for a takedown, she could end up in a very similar position that she ended that 10 minutes at.
Yeah, Izuki needs to look for that takedown, but you know, she's got to do something on her feet, because at this point in time, Lin Hichin is just thrown completely relaxed, and Izuki Hirata is not throwing a single strike that Lin Hichin has had to respect.
Every time Hirata goes for that double leg takedown, you talked about Hichin with the beautiful sprawl to get right back up.
Yeah, beautiful sprawl, but this is where Izuki wanted to get. So all she does really is use that double leg to close the distance. Once she gets that clinch, her hands are locked. She's sneaking around right now to the back. It'd be important for Lin Hechin to keep her back against the fence so Itsuki Hirata cannot really sneak around that backside. That's exactly what she did right there. Now her back's fully against the fence and Itsuki cannot sneak around to the back.
Yeah, she was able to turn in and get that underhook and that's what allowed her to swing back around.
Look at that nice little drop down to the single leg. Let's see if she can complete it. Reaps the leg, gets her down. It's important for Lin Hechin to work her way back up, and she does just that. But Itsuki starts to make her pay on the way up.
Yeah, eating some leather on the way up as Lin Hechin now takes a knee to the face. Hechin trying to work the body.
I thought for a moment that Itsuki was going to drop to the arm and guillotine.
Good job by Lin Hechin to turn Itsuki around and press her up against the wall now. Might be a good idea to disengage, but it looks like this front headlock position is keeping her pressed into this position.
Final 2 minutes of the fight. Hirata and Lin.
Good damage to the legs right there with the knees.
I'll tell you what, I'm looking at Hirata's leg right here in front of me on the cage, and man, she's going to have trouble walking this week.
Brutal damage to that left leg, but she is fighting hard. They're back up against the fence.
Itsuki, it looks like she's trying to time one of these legs so she can possibly trip or throw across. Just
there
like
it is.
That was beautiful.
Takedown for Lin Hechin.
If Itsuki can wrap it up here in these last 90 seconds, it would be a thing of beauty for Itsuki Hirata. Let's see if she can pass over. She likes this position. She floats over the top, but Lin Hechin ends up in the front headlock position.
Now Hechin looking to fire a right hook as Hirata comes off the canvas and they go toe-to-toe once again in the one circle with 107 remaining.
What a great scramble. Lin Hechin was in the furnace right there. That was Itsuki Hirata's primary best position that she could possibly be in. And with a minute left, I'm pretty sure she probably secured the victory at this point in time.
You can't count Itsuki Hirata up. All she needs is one more takedown. But she needs to press for it right there, just like that. She gets in tight, but Lin Hechin's doing a good job of framing off the face and keeping that distance.
Beautiful defense by Lin Hechin. 40 seconds to go. Backs her off with a jab as Hechin. Hirata will have to get aggressive inside the final 30 seconds here.
Hirata's got to go. There should be a sense of urgency. 30 seconds left.
Yeah, she had about a minute left, and she could have put the pedal down. But
to overcompensate for all the damage to the legs.
Man, what? She does so well right at the end of the round, right? She's able to get on top in the second, and then on the third, she gets the knockdown. But the other 4 minutes and 30 seconds of each one of those rounds is all Lin Hechin. What a matchup.
I'm glad I'm not a judge on this one.
Oh, 100.
I was just going to say, Rich, if you were a judge,
I'll tell you this, Brent, when we were talking with a minute left in the round, had Itsuki Hirata turned the gas on at that point, rather than just inside of 30, she would have had more time to work at the end, and perhaps Lin Hechin would not have been saved by the bell.
Back to Singapore with the official decision coming up. Back in Singapore, what a fight. Again, Lin Hechin in every round. You felt like she was in control for all but the final 30 seconds, and Hirata would kick it in late.
This is the story of Lin Hechin the whole match. She's keeping Itsuki Hirata at range. She's tenderizing that leg. Great job with the takedowns here. Great job with the takedown defense, I should say. Working off the cage, scrambling really well. But at the end, Itsuki Hirata was able to get on top and do what she does. And she was working this arm knowing that the time was running out. But Lin Hechin saved by the bell in that round. And then finally at the end of the match here, you see Itsuki Hirata land that big overhand right. And once again, she ends up on top. But Lin Hechin saved by the bell.
Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. It's okay. Hirata!
Unanimous decision for Hirata. How surprised are you, Rich?
I mean, I'm not surprised. Even though the decision was unanimous, that means that all the judges agreed, but it could still be a razor-sharp, razor-close decision.
The Dragon is with the winner.
I am here with your winner, Itsuki Hirata. What a performance. How confident were you when it went to the judges' scorecards?
Shikori, omedetou gozaimasu. Hantei o kiku made, kono shiai, kachi o kakushin shita deshou ka?
Ya, mou, 5-3 raundo zettai naru tte omotte tan de, saigo 1 fun tte kiita toki wa mou hontoni, imamade kitsukatta renshu no seika o dasu yori ganbarimashita.
5 minutes, 3 rounds. It's so tough fight, but I didn't give up, so I tried to finish her.
You were ultra confident every single time you went back to the corner. You seemed to grow. I know you went through a tough time after your last loss, but what a way to bounce back. You reinvented yourself, and what a right hand.
最後までとてもきつい試合ですけれども、最後の一撃についてどのように考えていたでしょうか？
いやもう選手やコーチとチームメイトと一緒にいっぱい対策もしたし、もう来るって分かってたのと、あと自分の得意な右のパンチ出して勝つ、ちょっとよく分かんないですけど、とにかくいっぱい練習しました。
I prepare for this fight so hard, and I know she's coming, and I know that this opportunity coming, and I punch her.
Yes, you did. Now, I know you're knocking on the door to the top five. How soon do you want to get back in here, and what do you want next?
次の試合について何か、目標などございますでしょうか？
前回めちゃめちゃ悔しい思いした。ジヒン、もう一回やろう。
I would like to rematch the Jihin.
I like that matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Itsuki Hirata!